Italy's volcanoes are quite famous, with thorough historical records for many of these complexes going back more than 2,500 years. For reference, the nation's active volcanoes exist here. But what if I were to tell you that another volcano also exists not too far from the city of Rome, as 21 kilometers southeast of Rome's city center, you reach Lago Albano, a massive, complex volcanic explosion crater that measures a whopping 4.2 kilometers long and 400 meters deep. This formed via multiple large explosive volcanic eruptions, but if you look around, other similar craters termed Maar also exist nearby. And, zooming out, two large caldera rims are also visible, representing the remains of ancient large-scale eruptions. This is the story of the Alban Hills volcano, which, while dormant, still, on rare occasions, can release volumes of carbon dioxide gas that have resulted in livestock fatalities, such as in October 1999, March 2000, and October 2001. In other words, while this dormant volcano's magma chamber hasn't presumably done much in multiple tens of thousands of years, it still exists. So, while the Alban Hills volcano is unlikely to erupt anytime soon, its long history of activity spanning nearly 600,000 years suggests that it could one day in the future reactivate and eventually erupt again. After all, in recent times, this old volcanic complex has seemingly only produced one or more eruptions about once every 30,000 to 40,000 years. So, why does this volcano exist in the first place? Like Campi Flegrei and Mount Vesuvius to the south, the Alban Hills volcano exists due to a convergent tectonic plate boundary to the east of the country. There, the African plate is subducting underneath the Eurasian plate. Partial melting then occurs on the subducted crust, causing molten rock to rise upwards, intruding into the Eurasian plate before rising underneath western Italy towards the surface, sometimes resulting in eruption and thus eventually forming a chain of volcanoes. However, the Alban Hills also formed at a natural weak point in the crust near the intersections of two lineaments, one trending northeast and one trending southeast. The first phase of the Alban Hills volcano was also its most active, slowly constructing the growing Tuscolano Artemisio stratovolcano. This stratovolcano likely grew to be taller and wider than the modern Mount Vesuvius, primarily through its central cone, but also through cinder cone-forming eruptions on its flanks. The lavas it produced were unusually alkali-rich. This cone-building phase continued for nearly 250,000 years, but we can divide this into two segments. The first segment between 610,000 and 460,000 years ago involved four VEI-6 and one VEI-5 explosive eruption that may have formed smaller calderas at its summit, while during the second segment, explosive eruptions were far larger but less frequent. Major VEI-6 eruptions occurred 457,000 years ago and 407,000 years ago until a truly catastrophic ultraplenian eruption occurred 350,000 years ago. This ultraplenian eruption created a more than 45 kilometer high eruption plume and sent pyroclastic flows in all directions that burned everything they touched, with some even reaching what are now the modern outskirts of Rome. Then, due to the large amount of erupted material, totaling a whopping 50 cubic kilometers of tephra, the ground overlying its magma chamber collapsed downwards to fill its empty space, forming a 10.4 kilometer wide caldera. The next phase of activity occurred within the center of the aforementioned caldera, building the much smaller Fetae stratovolcano. Volcanian eruptions originated from it between 350,000 and 260,000 years ago, only for its summit to also collapse into a caldera at the end of this period. Almost every eruption since then has occurred along the volcano's western half, where rising magma interacted with large volumes of groundwater flashing into steam, causing immense pressure to build, and then creating major explosions. These explosions also generated pyroclastic flows and surges which sometimes traveled multiple kilometers, forming various Maar explosion craters in the ground. The Arecia Maar formed 200,000 years ago, the Valle Marciana Maar formed 100,000 years ago, and the lake-filled Albano Maar formed via a combination of between 4 and 7 explosive eruptions dated to between 70,000 and 35,000 years ago. The Alban Hills volcano has not erupted since, and today provides textbook depictions of large-scale Maar explosion craters. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Nakartzi, for supporting my work.